Now, with the only tri-state forecast that's independently certified most accurate, here's meteorologist Eric Czarnitz.
Well, tonight I've been chatting with plenty of people on Twitter and on Facebook, and they're all saying the same thing, sliding through stop signs, doing 360s on roadways, and it's dangerous. And here's one of the reasons why. You take a look at the radar, and this indicates rain, all that green, right? And the air temperature is above freezing. In fact, the atmosphere is above freezing. The problem is the ground is still below freezing from that deep Arctic chill we had for the majority of last week. In fact, these temperatures here, close to freezing, but most of them above. Like Wilmington, Loveland, Harrison, Batesville now at freezing, and we're looking at Hillsboro at freezing. The problem is all of these recordings are taken right around here at head level, that's 6 feet off the ground. So once you get down to the surface, that's where you're sitting at 30, 31, 32, and that's why we've seen so much ice accumulation tonight. Now, eventually, these southerly winds will win out, will eventually warm things up, but it's not happening now for many spots, and I think tomorrow morning, at least until the sun rises, we're still going to have those issues. Futurecast showing most of our temperatures above freezing. Again, at ground level, I still think we're going to see some problems, especially for areas to the north of the Ohio River. Come 7:30 in the morning, Springboro, Mason, Wilmington, the air temperature here 32 degrees. So I suspect most of these spots across Butler, Warren, Clinton counties, even northern Highland County, and out around Franklin County, Indiana, still dealing with some ice. We may even see a little patchy ice here in Cincinnati, Harrison, and Loveland. Then as we go into the afternoon, more cold air builds in, changing the rain and freezing rain in the morning back over to some light snow by the afternoon. So we're not done with the system by a long shot. As far as the rest of tonight goes, I know we've seen some patchy freezing drizzle in northern Kentucky. I think once we get past about 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning, the majority of this will be rain. Still tomorrow morning, Cincinnati, Harrison, Loveland, Mason, Wilmington, untreated roadways could still be slick. And places further north like Oxford, Connersville, Springboro, and to the north of Wilmington, that's where I still expect there to be sub-freezing temperatures leading to slick roads again if those roads aren't treated. Another problem is all of this rain. Even if the roads have been treated, the rain washes the salt off, and then you see some of that freezing happening all over again. So the roads have to be treated multiple times. Now, the second half of the system is with this cold front. It moves through tomorrow, bringing some cooler temperatures and changing us back over to some freezing rain, sleet, and snow during the afternoon. This half of the system will be very light, but we could still see some slick conditions, especially as temperatures drop off for tomorrow evening's commute. So there's again problem number two. Precipitation chances, they dwindle during the afternoon, but again, it's the falling temperatures with all the rain and freezing rain we've seen tonight refreezing those roadways. And again, Futurecast shows that as that cold air builds in, us changing over to sleet, and then eventually some flurries. So your forecast not looking all that great tomorrow either. Tonight, our low 32 degrees, sleet, and freezing rain. Eventually, southern locations will warm up. We'll just see rain by the morning. Then tomorrow, we change back to a mix with some flurries. Our high set in the morning of 35 degrees. And your 7-day forecast, fantastic news here. Yeah, it's a busy commotion happening on Monday, but as we head through the rest of the week, sunny skies and warming temperatures by next weekend.